This audio production was made in collaboration with Audible Anarchist.
Modern man is plentifully equipped with political rights. He has the right of citizenship, provided he be virtuous, not an anarchist. He may elect his own rulers and jailers. He even enjoys, as one of the majority, the privilege of witnessing the government act in the name of the people. This privilege is a particularly bad hoax, because the activities of the government and courts have usually the sole purpose of intensifying the robbery and subjection of the people. In other words, the people, in their own scared name, doom themselves to dependence and slavery. The hollowness and sham of political rights becomes fully apparent when we consider that all of them combined do not include the right to live. The right to live, that is, the securing of the means of existence, the organization of society, in a manner to ensure to each the material basis of life and make it as self-evident as breathing, the right present society cannot give to man. The barbaric character of the dominant forms of existence is never so offensively demonstrated as when we subject the right to live to a critical test. This right is attacked and nullified daily in a thousand various ways by coercion, poverty, and dependence. It is cruel irony to justify the existence of the murderous machinery of government with its brutal, imbecile laws on the ground that it is necessary for the protection of life and property. Among the thousands of laws and statutes, there is not a single paragraph that guarantees to each member of society the right to live. The tender care for property is of little avail, for it is the chief characteristic of society based on the sanctity of property that the great majority do not possess sufficient property to justify the expense of machinery or police, courts, jailers, and hangmen. The right to live is primarily dependent upon possession and consequent power, but as only a small minority is in possession and control, the right to live remains a chimney so far as the majority is concerned. Anarchism regards the right to live as the pivot of its philosophy. It considers it the indispensable foundation of society that claims to be humane. Today the needy, the hungry, and the homeless man finds no providence, no court, where he may appeal the right to live, were he to claim it to test this right. He would soon find himself in the workhouse or prison. In the midst of fabulous wealth, he often lacks even the bare necessities of existence. He stands isolated, forsaken. At a glance, at every turn, he beholds a plentitude of food, clothing, and comforts, a thousandth part of which would save him from despair and destruction. But not even the minimalist right to live gives him the power over the things, lack of which turns him into a social pariah. What avails the rights of citizenship, political liberties, or he's one day sovereignty as voter, when he is deprived of the right to live and robbed of the use of the things he needs? When everything, every essential of life is the monopoly of a certain class, secured by laws, armies, courts, and scaffolds, it is evident that the possessing class will completely dominate life with the consequential subjugation of the rest of the people. The demand of the right to live is the most revolutionary demand of our day. The privileged are aware of it. Whenever the demand is voiced, seriously, where it is accompanied by corresponding action, where the disinherent resort to expropriation, to the general strike, the guardians of order at once realize that the banner of the social revolution is fluttering in the wind. Cetero senseo, what is today hypocritically called order, must fall and perish ere the right to live and become a joyous reality.
This has been a production of Audible Anarchist. You can find more Audible Anarchist on YouTube.